This is a contact sensor. People generally use them in their smart homes to figure out if doors or windows are open or closed. In this video, I'm going to show you how these contact sensors work, which ones I use in my home, and finally, some examples of some automations that I've got set up.
Hey, home automation guy. Start the show.
Contact sensors were traditionally used as part of home alarm systems and come with two parts. There's the read switch part, which is essentially two pieces of metal that are held slightly apart from each other, connected to a wire. Then the other part, which contains a magnet. Once you put the two pieces side by side, the magnet pulls the two pieces of metal together and they make contact, hence the name contact sensor. This completes the circuit and the alarm system or smart home hub knows that the two pieces are together. When you mount these on a door, one part goes on the door frame and the other on the door itself. When the door is closed, the magnet pulls the metal pieces together to create contact. This can then be used to trigger an armed alarm system or any other smart home automation. You can do the same thing for a window or a drawer. You can use them anywhere you want to detect if one thing is close to another thing. In most home security systems, these contact sensors are hardwired into the alarm system, which makes it difficult and expensive to fit them if you want to do all your doors and windows. But these days you can buy many battery-powered contact sensors that wirelessly connect to many smart home automation platforms like Amazon's, Apple HomeKit, or Home Assistant. They come in many different flavors and they can be connected to your home automation system via Wi-Fi, Z-Wave, or Zigbee, depending on which one you buy. Like most sensors in my smart home, I use a combination of Akara and Sonoff Zigbee contact sensors. The Akara one is on the left and the Sonoff on the right. Both of these sensors work in the same way. You have the main piece here on the left and the magnet piece here on the right. They can be mounted side by side like this or in several other configurations as well. This is great because it allows you to place them on many different surfaces and devices, such as here on my washing machine and here on my skylight. I'll tell you why I have a contact sensor attached to my washing machine in a minute, but for now, back to the sensors. The large side of both of these sensors can be opened up so that you can change the battery. The Sonoff uses a CR2032 battery, which is what most small Zigbee devices use, whereas the Akara uses a CR1632 battery. This is annoying because I now need to keep two different types of battery devices for when one of these need replacing. But it does mean that the Akara sensor is a lot smaller in physical size, which is good for discreetly mounting them around the house. I've been using both of these sensors for over 6 months now and I've never had to change the battery. Both manufacturers claim that the battery lasts over a year, but I've not been able to validate this yet. I assume the battery life will also depend on how often you open and close the doors and the temperature of where it's located. Just like the other sensors I've reviewed on my channel, the Akara once again feels more solid and well-built when compared to the Sonoff. In fact, when you shake the Sonoff, it rattles like a spray paint can, something the Akara does not do. To pair the Akara with a hub, you can press this little button here on the bottom. To pair the Sonoff, you need to put a pin or SIM pick into this little hole. Both of these devices come with specially cut pieces of double-sided tape, so you can mount them on your doors, windows, or wherever else you want to detect whether something is opening or closing. When it comes to reliability, they're both as good as each other. I once had a problem with a couple of my Sonoff sensors dropping off my Zigbee network, but that was after a power failure and they're located pretty far away from the Zigbee coordinator. I don't think it was a problem with the sensors themselves, I simply had to repair them and they've been working solidly ever since. Of course, I pair my sensors with Home Assistant, and they both expose relatively similar pieces of information via their entities. You can see here on the left the Akara sensor and the Sonoff one on the right. Both of them will tell you whether the door or window is open or closed. They provide you with the battery level and voltage and the signal strength as well. The Akara also seems to tell me the temperature of where the device is mounted, but I found this to be incredibly inaccurate and I wouldn't suggest using this measurement. Get an Akara temperature sensor if you want to measure temperature. With these sensors in Home Assistant, I'm able to create a range of different home automations, which I'll take you through briefly now. If you want to recreate any of them in your smart home, I've written a blog post which shows each automation in more detail, and that's linked in the description below. Some of my automations help keep my house secure. For example, in the summertime, I usually open the doors and windows to get air flowing and to cool down the house. Clearly, it's not good for home security if we go out and leave some of these doors and windows open. To prevent this, I have an automation in Home Assistant which is triggered when all of the residents leave the house, and a condition to check to see if any of the doors and windows are in an open state. If it finds one that's open, it sends me a notification telling me which one. A similar automation to this is triggered when I activate night mode. This is a Boolean helper in Home Assistant that I turn on when I'm heading to bed. This puts the house into a special state, which makes sure that all the curtains and blinds are closed, sets specific lights to turn on so I can easily find my way to the bedroom, and then turns those lights off again after a certain period of time. To turn on night mode, I can either click this switch in Home Assistant, turn it on automatically at a specific time, or scan an NFC tag somewhere in my house. When night mode is activated, this similar automation is triggered, telling me if I've left any doors or windows open, and which one. I have another automation that tells me if a door or window goes from closed to open while we're out. This tells me if someone has entered the house via the door or window when we're away. Maybe it's expected because I've given a key to a guest or a cleaner, but maybe someone's broken in. It's essentially the same as the automation I just showed you, but the trigger and conditions are swapped around. The trigger for this automation is any of the doors or windows changing state from closed to open. The condition instead checks to make sure that everyone is out of the house. You don't want to get a notification every time you open the door when you're home. So if everyone's out, the automation sends a notification telling us which door was opened. We can then check the security cameras if we think something suspicious is going on. It would be pretty surprising if someone could sneak up to my house and open a door or window without me first getting notified by one of my motion sensor automations. These automations get triggered when one of my security cameras detects a person and sends me a notification with a snapshot of what the camera saw. Whilst these notifications give me peace of mind a lot of the time, it's really annoying to get dozens of photos of my own face when I'm walking in and out of the door, unloading the car or something. To prevent this, I've added a condition to my camera notification automations to only send these if the front door is closed. I generally don't leave the front door open unless I'm nearby, popping in and out, so I don't need to see a picture of myself every single time. Now, contact sensors don't have to be all about security. You can also use them to make things easier around the house. I have a small attic space in my house and I can never seem to find the light switch for it. I used to stick my hand into the dark crawl space and fumble around until I felt the switch. It was really annoying. Now I use a contact sensor to automatically turn on these lights as soon as the door is opened and turn the lights off again 2 minutes after the door is closed. I didn't want them to turn off immediately as I'm worried about crawling into the attic space and having the door blow shut behind me in the wind, plunging me into darkness along with all of the little spiders that live in there. It may make more sense to turn the light off instantly when a door is closed in other spaces, though. For example, you could turn the light on when you open a large pantry or closet door, and have it turn off again when you close it. You could even turn on a totally different light if a door is opened. If you've got young children, you may want to get notified if their bedroom door opens after a certain time at night. Perhaps they had a bad dream, or need to go to the bathroom, and you want to make sure you know about this so you can go and help them. In this case, you could set some of the lights around the house to flash red when the child's bedroom door is opened. Here we have the automation that is triggered when the door's opened. A condition here makes sure that this automation only runs at nighttime. You don't want the house lights to randomly flash red throughout the day as the door is open and closed normally. In the action of the automation, I first take a snapshot of what the lights are currently set to using a dynamic scene. This will keep a record of whether or not the lights were switched on or off, what color and brightness level they were set to, so that they can go back to the same state once they've finished flashing. I then set the kitchen and TV lights to start flashing red. The flash is an effect that can be triggered using my Hue LED light strips, and other strips may support this as well. The automation then waits 16 seconds, which is how long these lights flash for. The saved information from the dynamic scene is then reapplied to the lights, so they go back to the brightness, color, and level settings from before. You can now go intercept your child in the hallway and make sure they're doing okay before they make it out to the living room and demand to stay up late watching TV with you.
Forever and ever and ever.
If you want more information about using scenes like this in Home Assistant, then check out the scenes video that I've linked in the description below. You can use this same concept in different ways as well. Instead of putting the contact sensor on a child's bedroom door, you could put it on the garage door or the mailbox flap, and set some lights to a specific color, letting you know that the garage door is open, or that you may have mail in the letterbox. Face it though, it's probably gonna be bills. If you've been watching my channel for a while now, you may have seen a previous video I did about making my dumb appliances smart. In that video, I explained how I often forget to empty the washing machine, and how I use smart switches to send me a message to my phone when it was completed. I'd hoped that this would remind me to empty it and stop my clothes from smelling like wet dog because I'd left them bunched up in the washing machine for hours on end. The problem was, though, that these notifications would generally come to my phone while I was busy upstairs. I'd dismiss the message and forget about it. I needed a way to remind me to empty the washing machine when I was near it. My washing machine is under the stairs next to the kitchen, and on those stairs, I have a motion-activated LED strip. I came up with a solution to change these lights to a green, rather than their normal warm white color, when the washing machine was done. This way, I could visually see that the washing machine needed attention when I walked up and down the stairs next to the machine itself. The only problem was figuring out how to tell the lights to go back to their normal color once the machine had been emptied, and that is where a contact sensor came in handy. In my previous video, which is linked in the description below, I created an automation that uses an input select helper in Home Assistant to keep track of what the washing machine is currently doing. I've now updated my automation so that it switches the washing machine state from running to unemptied when the cycle finishes. If the stair lights get turned on by the motion sensor automation, the action now checks the washing machine state. If the state is unemptied, it'll turn the stairwell lights on to green. If it's anything other than unemptied, it will turn the lights on to their normal warm white color. I then stuck a contact sensor to the door of the washing machine and created a new automation that's triggered when it's opened. The condition then checks to see if the current state is unemptied, and if it is, the automation will assume that I've opened the washing machine door to empty it. This will then set the washing machine state to off and notify us that it's been emptied. This has actually made a big difference, and we now consistently remember to hang the clothes as soon as we walk by the machine. These types of reminders, which remind you to do something when you're actually near the place that you need to do it, are far more effective than a generic message or push notification. My final contact sensor automation uses a very different style of contact sensor. This is an Akara water leak sensor, and it's designed to be placed anywhere you might be worried about flooding, such as near a boiler, some plumbing, or a dishwasher. The reason I call it a contact sensor is because it detects water using these two metal probes at the bottom of the sensor. When water passes across these two screws, it completes the circuit, or makes contact, telling you that there is water present. You can then use this to trigger an automation to notify you of a water leak, the same way as we did with door sensors earlier. I've built this water leak sensor into this 3D printed contraption, and wired it up to a rain detection pad. When a drop of water lands on this pad, it creates a contact between the two plates, and I use this to infer whether or not it is raining. This triggers an automation to send me a notification to tell me that it's raining. I also have a contact sensor on the skylight in my bedroom, and the rain detection automation checks if the skylight is open. If it is, it lets me know so I can go and close it before my bedroom carpet gets soaked. If you'd like to know more about my rain sensor, and how I use it to also prevent my watering system from turning on when it's been raining, please let me know in the comments and I'll consider creating a video entirely about this in the future. As I mentioned earlier, I've written a blog post which goes through all these automations in more detail, in case you want to recreate them in your own smart home. You can find a link to it in the description below. I regularly release videos about home automation and smart home ideas. Here's a video I made about smart TV automation, and here's another one I made about my favorite smart lighting automations. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up to let me know. Why not click the subscribe button while you're here so you can see when I release new home automation videos, and then together we can make your home smarter.